Hi everybody, John here again. This is going to be a video where I show three groups of records, records that have come my way for different reasons, but yeah, they're kind of mounting up now, so I'm going to try and show some of these. First of all, I'm going to show the records that I picked up while I was in Birmingham about 3 or 4 weeks ago, meeting up with the other UKVC people that met up there, including James Griffiths, Merely Chris, John Headley, and Steve Whitty. So we went to a shop, which I believe was called the Discariot or something like that. And this was one of the records I bought from that shop. It's called Dinosaur Swamps. It's by The Flock. What drew me to this was that I'd just in recent weeks picked up, or actually now I bought a copy of their first album, which I'll show at a separate time, yeah, so, and this was another one of theirs, and it was the right price and I grabbed it. It's sort of jazz, rock, fusion, a little bit sort of proggy, well, it's quite proggy actually. Great stuff, and that is on CBS Embassy. Another record I picked up there was this. This is by a band called Druid, a record called Towards the Sun. As soon as I saw this, I recognised it, and I thought, what is it that I recognise about that record? I knew that it was progressive rock, and I knew it was something that I'd sort of earmarked for some reason, because I knew that it was of interest to me even before I'd heard it, and that's only a lie. So what it was that they're sort of like one of these bands that people would often hold up as saying that they're a Yes sound-alike, that they sound a bit like Yes. Starcastle is another good example of that. And I don't know if all of their albums sound like Yes, but this one does. It's got a certain quality to it that you could argue was Yes influenced. I mean, I'm talking about classic Yes here from the sort of the early to mid 70s. Really great to have it. You can see that this record cover gives it away a little bit with this sort of Roger Dean style sort of environment here. It's not by Roger Dean, but you can see how it's just inspired by Roger Dean. Yeah, I'd probably do a little bit of a needle drop of this because it's a very good record.
As the shadows of the night that's all around with them,
is the third one. We bought at a different record shop. I can't remember what it was called now. So this is Degeneration by a band called Loud. Showed this in my last video. It's a band I saw as a supporting act to Andy Taylor. Yeah, sort of late 80s, early 90s. He was playing at the Marquee in London, and these were the supporting act. They were giving out free cassettes there. I got it somewhere stashed away in a box somewhere in the loft. But I don't know how I'd describe them. They seemed very sort of new metal at the time. I don't know if that's an appropriate way to describe them. But you can tell how, yeah, they're a hard rock band. I don't know if I'd say they were metal or not, possibly. But they're a long way from the sort of traditional sort of, Iron Maiden style of metal. Not a bad band. I still think of them as being a new band, but obviously they're not. I'm going to do a needle drop of this album too. There's a track called Song for the Lonely, I believe I'm going to play. And see if you can tell me who they sound a bit like when they play that song. So the next batch of records I'm going to show now is the batch that came to me in the post from Rob Walker, because I co-won his contest together with Randall Weaver, who was the other winner, the other name pulled out of the hat. So the prize was, for Rob's contest, VCLT from him, and also you could choose a record online on Amazon, and he would pay for it and arrange for it to be sent to you, which is what he did. Well, actually, I think he took it home and then sent it from his together with the VCLT. I'll start off by showing what he sent as VCLT. This is Yellow Flag. I definitely remember them from their time in the charts. I think they're a French band, aren't they? This is a really good record. I haven't got it. I haven't got anything by them, but it's sort of an amazingly produced record. You know, sonically, it's right there. You need to set time sort of apart and listen to this very carefully, because the production is just fantastic. And it's mainly sort of what's the word I'm looking for? Yeah, it's mainly sort of instrumental style music. There is voices in it, but you know, it's good stuff. I like this. Thanks very much, Rob, for sending that. It's probably not a record I would have picked up myself, which is why it kind of makes it fun to receive it, because you know, you give things a second listen, don't you, when somebody sends it to you. Rob also sent me a copy of Kiss Alive, the double live album. When I was reading up about this, recently, I found out, and Steve Whitty spoke about this in a video around about the same time, was that Alive was inspired by Slade Alive, the live album by them. Apparently they Kiss were big fans of Slade, and they wanted an album that kind of had the same sort of raw sort of energy in their live performance, and that's why it's called Alive. Yeah, great record. Thanks very much. Lovely stuff. I've been listening to this. My son particularly enjoys it. He's sort of early, is he? Yeah, 11 now. So he's starting to, you know, show an interest in rock music and hard rock music. And when he saw this cover, he was, you know, pretty impressed. Great stuff. But the record that I asked Rob to send me from Amazon was this one. It's in a Blake cover. So, Cherry 5 by Cherry 5. This has been a grail of mine for some time now, and I will have to say that this is easily the best album that I've acquired this year so far. So it's sort of one of those sort of lost gems, if you like, in terms of progressive rock. Brilliant stuff. Definitely going to do a little bit of a needle rock of this. If you like prog, if you like intricate sort of, you know, technical playing, lots of varying tempos and time signatures and stuff like that. It's all in here. Really good band, really good record. I don't have anything by them, and I've been sort of spying out this one. And yeah, when Rob said I should let him know what I'd like him to get for me, I just checked, and yeah, I think this is a relatively new re-release, because I've been looking for a long time and not seen it really at a price that I'm happy to pay. And this was perhaps on the upper limit of what I would have spent on a record. But Rob was very gracious and bought it and sent it to me. So, brilliant. Thank you very much, Rob. Excellent record. Hope you enjoy the needle drop. Items I'm going to show now is some VCLT that I received from James Griffiths it's been a couple of months ago now, I suppose. Time goes so quickly. James sent completely unannounced a sort of a great big chunky box through the post, and it arrived, and I wasn't expecting anything at all. And it sort of was quite nice to receive because opening up, it felt a bit like a, you know, little sort of rescue hamper. And inside the box was this book called Scarecrows by Robert Westall. James sent this, and he did say in an email, "I think I'm going to send you something," but he didn't go into more detail than that. I'd spoken before about an album called Hey Man Dreams by Cosmograph, which was you know, a progressive rock album based around the theme of a scarecrow in a field. And I spoke quite a lot about, you know, my feelings about that and memories of Wurzel Gummidge and the sort of the backstory that I always think I know in the Wurzel Gummidge sort of folklore type stuff. James sent me this, obviously a book he'd read before, and it's sort of like a bit of a ghost story, I suppose. Quite a nice novel. Really enjoyed reading it. Really good read. Thanks very much, James. James suggested I read it with my or to my children, or, but I think it'd probably scare them a bit. So in the box, also on that similar theme, there's a couple of CDs. One was by a band called Candidates. The album was called Nuada. I don't have the CDs to hand. I think I've probably still got them in the car at the moment. Yeah, so this Nuada was, it's kind of like a folky type, sort of ethereal, sort of folky kind of acoustic kind of music. And it went quite nicely with this. I originally took that CD with me on my trip to Sweden in the hope that I could play it in the car, in this rental car. But these days, rental cars apparently don't come with CD players. I wish they did. Or at least I think they should charge you less if they don't have a CD player in. Anyway, so I had to wait until I got back home to sort of really get into that. And yeah, whilst I was reading the book, listening to that CD, and it sort of went quite nicely together. Anyway, the records that James sent were, this one was Rick Derringer, All American Boy. I got this from James at around about the same time as I got the Mick Ronson solo album, Don't Worry, Just Play. And they're quite similar, those two records, in that, you know, they're sort of guitar-driven rock music by guitarists, and they're kind of upbeat, you know. I mean, they would sit quite nicely back to back, those two albums, on a C90, for instance. This is, you know, it's not a million miles away from that. Obviously, a different style of playing. But you know, it's still very much a showcase for his playing and his songwriting is great in this. So Rick Derringer, as I understand, he used to play with Edgar Winter and also Steely Dan. Yeah, great album. Thanks very much, James, for sending that. Again, it's not one that I would have known about or, you know, necessarily picked up for myself, but I'm glad that I have it because sort of brought new things to me. This box that James sent was this great big collector's box set, Collector's History of Classic Jazz. It's sort of like a five record set of jazz, and it sort of covers a lot of ground, and it's really quite thorough because it starts off already on sort of the first side of the first record with examples of African tribal music. You know, it's got right back to the roots. And here's a song called Black Woman, which is described as a Negro prison song from Mississippi State Prison. You know, so it's sort of really sort of right back looking at the roots of jazz, I suppose. It goes through ragtime and boogie-woogie, then goes into the New Orleans and Dixieland style, and then it goes into the blues. Interestingly, I wouldn't have thought, you know, I would have thought that was a sort of different branch, but it includes blues, and it sort of has some quite, you know, blues music like by Lead Belly, for instance, and Big Joe Williams. Memphis Slim. I wouldn't have necessarily kind of thought of that as being a stage in jazz, but hey, what do I know? And then it goes on to the Harlem and New York scene, and the last record is modern jazz. You've got, you know, people like Charlie Mingus on there, Dizzy Gillespie, Sonny Rollins, and the last, very last side is Big Bangs and Swing Era. Yeah, it's very thorough. This is the first thing out of the box that I listened to. I listened to it all the way through, starting from the first side and playing all the way through to the last side. What a journey that was. great record, a lot of fun. Thanks very much, James. And the big grail that James included in that box was this record. Getz and Gilberto. This has been a record that I've sort of had my eyes out for a long time. I think it was Daddy Silva, the VC guy, who included this once in a list of records that everybody has. And yeah, fair enough, he showed a lot of records that everyone has, and I probably have most of the ones that he showed, but I didn't have this one. In fact, I'd never heard of it before, and at the time I was kind of newly turned on to jazz, so I thought, oh, what's that, and looked it up, heard little samples, and thought, yeah, I gotta get that. But yeah, didn't see it around. I mean, just didn't see it around in the wild or anything. I did eventually find a Stan Getz compilation album, which was good. I bought that and really enjoyed that. But yeah, this record eluded me for a long time. And yeah, lo and behold, James knew that I was looking for it and found this and sent it to me. So that was a fantastic record to get. I've played the hell out of this, you know, when I got it, especially. It didn't leave my turntable for a long time. So, thanks, James, for that hamper rescue package box. Really great stuff. Really good of you to send that. I'll say once more, thanks to Rob Walker for the VCRT he sent and the prize that I won. Thanks to the other VC guys that I met up with in Birmingham. Had a good time. Looking forward to the next get together, hopefully in Bristol. And say thank you for watching. Hope everyone's doing well. Check out my next video. Thanks. Bye.